that whole trip was full of incidents. He was assaulted, he was refused admission in a hotel.
But then he saw that these innocent Zulus had been so badly treated. Gandhi saw the horror of violence, and he saw the need to find something that can fight injustice without inviting this terrible retribution. And it came to him that a non-violent struggle, absolutely fearless, you are prepared to pay a full price.
Gandhi was clearly the most creative human being who lived in the 20th century in his lifetime.
He carried freedom struggle, but according to thousand-year-old India's tradition, non-violence, ahimsa.
And he had been very, very clear on this, that it was Indian cooperation with the British Raj that enabled it to succeed.
He is bending down and scooping up some salt in his hand on the seashore. Is a sign of the average Indian person defying the mighty empire.
From where I stood, I heard the sickening wags of the clubs on unprotected skulls.
What do? Do you take 50,000 people and try and put them into prison? People in Whitehall were left scratching their heads thinking, well, how do we deal with opponents like Gandhi?
Say that I got my inspiration from Christ, but my technique from Gandhi.
We must continue to delve deeper into the philosophy of nonviolent resistance. That is something about this method that has power.
I said to President Barack Obama on occasion, I said, Mr. President, if it hadn't been for Gandhi and Martin Luther King Jr., you wouldn't be President of the United States of America.
Apartheid was designed to strip every black person, every Indian person, of dignity and self-respect.
There are many people who feel that it is useless and futile for us to continue talking peace and non-violence.
If you want to ask why the Berlin Wall came down in November 1989, because solidarity was not crushed.
Gandhi film, Richard Attenborough's, shown here, it was not about Gandhi and British and India, it was about us.
Václav Havel is a playwright, and he directs the greatest work of political theatre in European history. What we saw between 1979 and 1989 was the birth of a new kind of revolution, non-violent revolution, velvet revolution, in which a nuclear armed communist empire, the Soviet empire, just softly and suddenly vanished away.
Gandhi is the expression of all forms of dissent, and our world needs dissent, needs disobedience, needs to disobey unjust laws.
Today we no longer have a choice between violence and non-violence. It is either non-violence or non-existence.
I am sad. I am.